Time now for an update from Fox Carolina News and Fox Carolina weather. Weather rates certified most accurate.
Good Friday evening. I'm Cody Alcorn. Of course, it's Friday Night Blitz. We'll have all of the action coming up at 10:30. And of course, if you miss it at 10:30, we'll have it under the Friday Night Blitz section at foxcarolina.com. The first place for all of your highlights. And of course, we have the Coach of the Week, Spirit of the Week, and Senior Shoutouts as well. So make sure you check those out. And there's also a place where you can nominate all of those too, all at foxcarolina.com. Speaking of our website, let's look at some of the top stories right now. Spartanburg police have identified that guy, Daryl Emery, as the man who tried to carjack two drivers and then successfully pulled a woman out of a third vehicle at the Sonic in Spartanburg yesterday evening. Her 11-year-old daughter was able to jump out and get to safety. Now, this guy, Daryl Emery, was tracked down in Cowpens a little later on Battleground Road and was arrested. He is facing a slew of charges this evening, but he is locked up tonight in Spartanburg County. Also, so we've been talking a lot about the hurricane coming to the Gulf Coast, the possible track through our area. Well, in the meantime, North Carolina Governor Roy Cooper asking for the federal government to issue a declaration to get help for our neighbors up in Haywood County, Transylvania County, Swain County, I think it's Mitchell County. A lot of counties we haven't talked a lot about, so there they are right there. Avery, Buncombe, Haywood, Madison, Transylvania, Yancey, and Watauga counties. All of those hit hard by Tropical Storm Fred. And they're really hoping for federal assistance that will help get these folks, property cleaned up. If they have to rebuild, it will really help that and the infrastructure, because there's so much damage to the infrastructure across those western North Carolina counties. And of course, fingers crossed that we do not see anything from Ida, but we'll say this. It is going to be, if it stays on this track, catastrophic for the Gulf Coast. Let's bring in Chief Meteorologist Kendra Kent. And we don't want to see this go anywhere, but we definitely don't want to see any of the remnants come through here, because what we saw with Fred, we do not need to repeat in the mountains.
No, we cannot let that happen. But, you know, obviously weather has a mind of its own, and we will be watching this closely. But for now, it does not look like we're going to get the brunt from Ida. Of course, Louisiana will get that. And it doesn't even look like it's going to come all that close to us at this point. At this juncture, we're looking in a landfall in Louisiana near Baton Rouge up toward New Orleans on Sunday. Local impacts Tuesday into Wednesday with some showers, possibly a few stronger storms. Flooding looks less likely, but it can't be ruled out. We'll be watching for it. Tonight, 70 degrees, though, with partly cloudy skies in the mountains. A few showers early on, but clearing later on tonight. And then we'll be looking toward dry weather both Saturday and Sunday, with highs in the low 90s in the upstate and upper 80s across the mountains. Of course, you'll want to check in with us on the 10 and 11 o'clock newscast tonight and throughout this weekend on the 10 o'clock news.